Hey guys, gonna read from Galatians chapter 5. But first, as always, I always start my videos with the true given name for the anointed Messiah. The anointed Messiah. There are plenty messiahs, but there's only one anointed Messiah. And his name can be found in Isaiah 7, verse 14. Therefore the Most High himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel. Now if you turn over to Matthew 1, verse 22 through 23, you will see that the prophecy in Isaiah was fulfilled, according to scriptures, that is. Matthew 1, 22 to 23. Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken of the Most High by the prophet, saying, Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is Mighty El with us. And that's the name I honor and praise, Emmanuel. Now we go to Galatians 5, 13 through 26. I'm just going to read about the spirit of lust and the spirit of flesh. For brethren, you have been called unto liberty. Only use not liberty for an occasion to the flesh, but by love, and serve one another. For all the law is fulfilled in one word, even in this: you shall love your neighbor as yourself. But if you bite and devour one another, take heed that you be not consumed one of another. This I say then, walk in the Spirit, and you will not fulfill the lust of the flesh. For the flesh lusts against the Spirit, and the Spirit against the flesh, and these are contrary to one another, for that you cannot do the things that you would. But if you be led of the Spirit, you are not under the law. Now the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulations, wrath, strife, seditions, heresies, envyings, murders, drunkenness, revelings, and such like, of the which I tell you before, as I have also told you in time past, that they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of Almighty El. For the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law. And they that are Messiahs have crucified the flesh with the affections and lusts. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. Let us not be desirous of vain glory, provoking one another and envying one another. Guys, if you don't know the definitions, you know, of what Shaul was talking about, you know, like revelings and seditions, heresies, you know, look them up, because there's a lot of different meanings. So I just want to read that, and I guess my message here would be that we all of us, have to look in that mirror and check ourselves thoroughly and change what is not of the Most High.